Welcome back to the Cold 45 Show. Welcome to this Monday. Kevin's a little early Monday already. We're only 30 days away till Christmas. Huge week. It was a great weekend. this is it for all my Viking fans. On our game yesterday, I couldn't do my video yesterday because I went to the Eagles Rams game. You guys hate me, I know. I'm a Vikings fan with the Eagles Rams. I wanted to see it. I put pictures and look again, maybe against one of them. And also, not because of that, it was my family man, my uncle and everybody else got tickets. Got us tickets to the game. So I guess my uncle. Okay, I told you guys my aunt owns a dance studio. Somewhere like dancers, we're gonna dance with the cheerleaders. Like they had like this little group session, little kids. Man, oh, there's something kind of sounding good. Dancers. Some of the little dancers were gonna go on the field and do a dance with some of the cheerleaders from the LA Rams. So she's like, oh yeah, we have tickets. She has tickets. My dad paid half for the tickets, and this is like part of our Christmas gift. You know, so some of me. My dad, my brother, my uncle, my cousin, and a family friend of ours that's been a family friend of us for a long time, and another friend that's been a family friend of us for a long time now, and I knew for a while that went. So it was like seven of us went to the game. So, it's fun. My brother, diehard Eagles fan, and I went to the game. There's so much green, you guys don't know. Philly fans travel. You know, it don't matter where they're playing. It could be like up in freaking North Dakota or Wyoming. They'll be there. You know, it could be in the middle. It could be up in Canada, and they'll be there. I'm telling you, they travel. Like there was more green at this game than you saw. Like than Rams blue and dark blue and Rams retro blue with the yellow and all that. And there's more green than that. Like I'm telling you, where we sat was just a slew of just Eagles fans. Everybody's like, yes, I'm happy. I'm not next to just a bunch of Ram bums. You know, it was a fun game. It was a tense game. The crowd was getting into it. I was getting into it for some reason. You know, it's a fun game. It's not your team. It's a Coliseum. The Coliseum has been around for decades and decades. That's a retro stadium. The seats were old, but it don't matter. Fans were there. They packed. That's like a 90,000 seat stadium. That's probably the most biggest stadium in probably sports history, you know, because they had the Olympics there right there. And they're going to have the Olympics there again in 2028 in Los Angeles. And the UC Trojans really packed the stadium for those games. But UC Trojans, they love the UC Trojans. And like literally, like you step out of that stadium, right next door is the new stadium for the soccer team, for the MLS team, Los Angeles Football Club. It's like right, like literally, they're like literally like this. So you see the stadium for the Coliseum, it's like that. That's how close they are. So if they have a game for soccer or for whatever, you know, Trojans or Rams. Stuff like that. Kind of soccer team supposed to play the next year, but anyways. And before I get started here, if you guys don't know, I've been watching YouTube for a while, and all you guys, I know, not sports related, but if you guys watch YouTube, you guys know who the Ain't Grapple is. If you guys don't know who the Ain't Grapple is, go look at some of his videos. He's an old guy that his son always filmed him. He was always mad, and it was just funny, entertaining videos. And he passed away yesterday at the age of 67. I think it was a liver problem back in the day. Before he even made videos, he used to be, I guess, what? They said he used to be a drinker, so he did get liver failing problems or something, I don't know. I think it was one of those, so he passed away today. It really broke my heart. It was really sad, and I'm still mourning over it. It's so hard for all of us people who have watched him. He's been around for 10 years. He's been, like, entertaining for 10 years. He's been on True TV and, like, other TV shows. I think maybe Tosh would know. I don't know if he's on Ridiculousness, but he's been on there. They show some of his clips, you know. He's been on TV, and it's crazy. He still has a son. His son was the one who filmed him. His son is still going to be doing his videos because his dad said, you know, when I die, I don't want you to stop making those videos. So he ain't going to stop. And it's very sad and hard, you know. I'm still mourning over it. I'm still in shock. I hope I can get to this Monday because it's a tough day. When I came home from the game, I was on my Facebook and stuff. And I saw it, and I literally just broke down in tears. I was like, serious? But anyways, besides that, all my Vikings fans, we did lose the game yesterday. We're not going to lose. Sorry about that. took it on my own. So I have we lost the game today, but we're not going to give up hope. We're not going to give up. We're going to go 13-3. I'm telling you guys this. We're going to go 13-3. You know, the Eagles did win yesterday. They're 11-2, and they just lost Carson Wentz. Torn ACL, so he's done for the rest of the season. They got Nick Foles. Nick Foles had a couple good plays at the end. You know, decent plays, but I think he mostly just gave the ball to run the ball to Blunt or to J.J. And some guy at the Eagles Rams game yesterday had a sign. It was freaking hilarious. I want to take a picture of it. It said, "Roll the J, pass the Blunt." Could J.J. roll the J? And then Garrett Blunt passed the Blunt, and I was like, that was probably the best sign. And people were popping for that sign, man. Like, man, I gotta think about that sign. And it was like, it was crazy. And some guy had like this like suit. It looked like, you know, like a suit. What do you call it? Like freaking just like a dress suit. It was the Eagles one. He wore that. I'm like, dude, I was lit. And they were like, Where'd you get that? He looked freaking sick of that thing. He's like, I got it from Amazon. Like this like dress suit thing. It was all dicked on green. It had Eagles written all over it. There's some hot girls, man. Those Eagles fans are some hot Eagles fans. Just saying. Even if they wear the color, they don't really watch. They don't really know. There's some hot Eagles fans. But anyways, I think Minnesota can show up tonight. But yeah, some hot girls. Anyways, so I'm going to run down the game real quick. Remember, I was on the way to LA. I'm like, it's 10 o'clock. So let's see if they have the game on the TV. So like, okay, so we check if they have the game on the TV. I mean, on TV, on the radio. And apparently, so they did. Come on, they had the game on the radio. It was like the Mighty 1090, which is like San Diego sports and radio news. And I was on the way to LA, so I'm like, oh, shoot, they had the game. So I heard half of it, and Then we got there. Like, I only got to hear, like, 30 minutes of the game because we got there early because we wanted to eat. Because they had the NFL Fox Sunday booth all set up, and they had all the retro Rams players, like Dickerson, all the old guys there. You know, they had the NFL Fox Sunday. You know what they do in San Diego over the NFL Fox Sunday? They did the outside. You know what they call it? They had it all set up. It was pretty cool. But anyway, just run down the game. We lost by a touchdown and a field goal, 24-31. You can see all the sudden glare in my eyes. Case Keenum went for 27-44, 280 yards, 2 touchdowns, but that was nothing. You know, he threw an interception. I don't know how many interceptions he did, but I was on the radio. The first play we kicked up the game, he threw an interception, touchdown. I was like, really? And my brother's like, oh. My brother told me, oh, Teddy Bridgewater was going to come in now. Let's see. You know, just one interception. He threw a couple interceptions during his crucifix at the Vikings, and we still won games. Just because he lost one in the interception. Or I don't know how many interceptions he did, but I know it was all one. You know, Jerry McKinnon went for 7 carries, 46 yards. Adam Thielen, 6 receiving, 105 yards, 1 touchdown. Let's see. Like I said, Case Keenum. Oh, okay. Case Keenum was 27. 44, 280 yards, 2 touchdowns, 2 interceptions. I don't know. Are you guys ready for Bridgewater? I'm not. I'm still not. I don't know. Case Keenum for the last 3 games. You're going to put in Bridgewater for the last 3 games, and what? And the rest of the playoffs for Bridgewater? Or, you know, for the Eagles, it's hard for them because they lost Carson Wentz, and all they have now, they have is Nick Foles. And Nick Foles, when I saw him play yesterday, like, he played like at the last quarter, like maybe like 4 or 5 minutes into the last quarter. He came to the game. All he did was run the ball. He threw a couple plays, but they're okay. You know, he got their summer receiving catches, which is great. Some of them are like, eh. So, it wasn't the best, but, you know, it's going to be hard for the Eagles with Nick Foles. Jerry McKinnon, okay. For rushing, Case Keenum went for 5 rushing, 40 yards. Jerry McKinnon went for 7 rushing, 46 yards. Murray went for 9 rushing and 14 yards. Adam Thielen, 6 receiving, 105 yards, 1 touchdown. Kyle Rudolph, 3 receiving, 41 yards, 1 touchdown. Treadwell, 2 receiving, 23 yards. Diggs, 6 receiving, 64 yards. Right, 2 receiving, 13. McKinnon, 2 receiving, 9. Ham, 1 receiving 9. Bell, 2 receiving 7. Murray, 2 receiving 6. And Floyd, 1 receiving 3. Today, who had the most tackles was 6. Griffin, 2. Kai Forbes, 3 field goals made. Extra points were good. Shields, 1 return, 27 yards. Brown, 1 return, 17 yards. Shields, 5 return, 54 yards. Punt returns. So I didn't really hear, I didn't see the game on TV, but they did have the highlights. They go to the Coliseum and they always show like, oh, score update. And they have the NFL Red Zone on the TV, so they show the highlights of our game. And it wasn't pretty. You know, I was disappointed. I tried to hide all my Vikings skullness in me, you know? Skull. And they had the E-L-G-L-E-S Eagles. They got the Eagles chant going on, but they're sort of sick. I gotta tell you, like the other far side, because of the Eagles, they didn't say it. We should have got Eagles Vision Sign. It would be more better. But the other side of the field is just all Eagles Vision Sign. It's packed full of green arts. It's packed full of green, too. But they got the Eagles Vision Sign. We got the Rams. So we're doing E-L-G-E-S Eagles. My brother, all the fans, all the Eagles fans, are doing it. And they're all the same. And you have the bottom, the front row doing it. And after we did, the front row did it. And everybody was just asking, can we all do it as one? Like, I'm at the base, I can do it as well. Like, we're all just out of sync. It's like, it didn't make any freaking sense. You know, but it's still fun. So they had the game on the day, so like, you know, the Seahawks game, and all the Rams were happy because the Seahawks lost. But, you know.
Now, what happened to the Vikings yesterday, man?
I know.
Have a good one.
Me too. And, yeah, it's just, initial of the game, I was like, oh, disappointed, but did it. But it's only one loss. It's only one. It's only one there. We're 3-10. We're going to finish out 13-3. I'm telling you this is the truth. As you know, and you know, like the Reds, we're going to lose the rest 3. We're going to be 10-6. Nope. I want to finish off this rest of the season strong, 13-3. You know, have a great freaking Christmas on a 13-3. You know, it's only 3 games, so next week, we're going to have that. Boom, boom, Christmas, so whatever. We have 13 more days till Christmas, so let me know in the comments down below what you're going to get for Christmas. Are you getting any Viking things related? I'd like to know. We lost the game, but one by touch and field goal. I think I'll keep Case Keenum in. I'll keep him in until next game. Next game he does bad, and then I'll put a bridge on it. But for now, Case Keenum's staying in. That's me. Anyway, thank you guys for watching this video. Like, you guys know what you guys think. Bridgewater. I don't know yet. Let's get Case Keenum one more game. We got this. We're ending up at 13-3. Let's go Skull Vikings. I'll see y'all later. Bye, y'all. And one more thing. All my Vikings fans live in L.A. I'll be in L.A. next year for Vikings Rams at the Coliseum. Hope you guys show up. Skull Vikings. Let's do this. Let's bring our Vikings nation to L.A. next year. It looks like to me they don't have time or date yet, but it looks like it's week 12. So week 12, I'm assuming that gets around November. We'll be there. Skull Vikings. Let's go, baby. Bye, y'all.